Dr. Swachhla, Scientific Director with Ziva Fertility Centers. Have you ever gotten a semen analysis done and the report stated something called as globozoospermia? Have you heard about it but don't know what it is? Please continue listening to this video. Globozoospermia is a very rare male condition. Basically, it leads to infertility because of the shape of the sperm. That's why it's called globozoospermia. Globo is round, so the shape of the sperm is not what it is supposed to be. To understand that, first let's take a look at the shape of the sperm. A sperm has a head, a midpiece, and a tail. The head has all the genetic material packed inside it very nicely, tightly, which comes from the father. The midpiece has mitochondria, which is the battery of the cell, which is the sperm. And the tail gives the sperm motility, which is required. Now, if the sperm head is looked more carefully, it has a small upper cap layer on its head, which is called as acrosome layer. Now, this layer is very, very critical for the sperm to interact with an egg. And only when this interaction happens, an enzyme is released by the acrosome layer and the sperm can enter and fertilize the egg. So this is a very critical procedure for fertilization to happen. The sperm reaches the egg, the acrosome reacts with the egg and releases a special enzyme, after which the sperm is able to enter the egg and fertilize it. So now you understand how important this is. In cases of globozoospermia, the acrosome is absent and it is round in shape instead of oval. When the head is round and not oval, then it is called as globozoospermia. It is a very rare condition and it is an autosomal recessive disorder of the gene which is DPY19L2. You don't have to remember it, but just have to understand that it is an autosomal recessive. Means it's not necessary for your offspring to get this issue as well, for sure. So you understand now that it is a genetic cause as well. It could be some kind of a mutation that you've had and that's why your sperm is like that. Now, how can you tackle this problem? Basically, we decide on whether the entire sperms in the sample are globozoospermia or only partial. Is it seen that some sperms also have the acrosome cap? Now, how do we differentiate this? We have to be very careful that we analyze this properly. So on your part too, when you get your semen analysis done, please visit a good center where they have the proper microscopes to assess whether this sperm has all the parts that are required for fertilization. On our part, we look at whether the entire sample is globozoospermia or some sperms are also normal. When the entire sample is globozoospermia, that is the heads are very small and round instead of oval, then the option is IVF. What we do is we take the sperms, put them in a special solution which activates the sperm because the acrosome is not there, so they are activated. And when we utilize these sperms to fertilize the eggs through IVF, the fertilization occurs and there is a very good chance that embryos will be formed. These embryos can then be transferred into the uterus of the wife naturally, like any other IVF cycle, and success rate can be achieved. If you want to understand more, if you have been diagnosed as having globozoospermia or you want to get it checked, please feel free to contact us, because if you leave this problem, it is very difficult for you to get pregnant on your own, because the sperms, if they do not have the acrosome cap, many patients try on their own and fail to achieve pregnancy because of this small problem, which can be tackled with IVF. Please feel free to contact us. Thank you. A lot of effort has gone into making this video. Please like and subscribe us. Thank you.